Today I'm going to share a C# trick on how to make LINQ faster using an amazing library that I've discovered. As you can see, I'm in a box in the corner of the screen. No theme song, no yapping today, just code. All right. So to demonstrate LINQ, we're going to create a nice list of viewers of this channel. So we're going to viewers, enumerable, dot repeat, new, subscriber, full name, Barry. We give them an ID of a new grid, to string, and quite possibly we can then do is subscribed true, obviously, because everybody that views this channel is subscribed. Yeah, that's right. So we repeat this list and create, let's say, 200 viewers, something like that. And here is some code I wrote earlier. So fix the stopwatch, yeah, using system diagnostics. Right, so what this is going to do is demonstrate some really rudimentary LINQ usage. It's going to create a where clause for where they are subscribed. This will be true for everybody, obviously. And then add to the sub count. What we then want to do is print it out to the console, like so. And let's just, for posterity's sake, see how long this takes. So we'll run the app with C#. We'll start our project. And in the console, it's going to run the app. This is going to be super slow because we're doing a million iterations over 200 viewers, subscribers. I've got 2,303 milliseconds. That's not great. If we add to list to this, so it's a fair test later, and run the app, we'll get about 3,700 milliseconds, so 3.7 seconds, like so. Now here's the loop again underneath. But this time we're going to use this brand new library that we've discovered called ZLinq. It's a zero allocation link library for .NET written by a Japanese Microsoft MVP called Kawai Yoshifumi. What a legend. He's just released version 1, so we're celebrating with a video. It is obviously on GitHub as well. It's been going on quite a while. It's a niche library that is mainly used by Unity and now Godot developers, who want maximum performance. And while it's faster, it's actually the lack of allocations, which is the most important thing for game developers, of course. So what we can do, we can find .NET add package like that, get back to our app. And in the terminal down below, we can install the package. Straight off nuggets, that's what we like, right. So in order to use ZLinq instead of LINQ, we just hit in here as value enumerable, like so, and everything after as value enumerable is ZLinq and does its magic. So we can update this text here and run the app and see just how much faster it is. Let's go. Come on, ZLinq. Do us proud. So 3.9 seconds, 2.5 seconds when using ZLinq. That is over a third off the time it took to iterate. Now, if you're doing LINQ in game loops or high performance systems, this could mean the difference between having a slow game or winning or losing money if you're doing a high frequency trading solution. So I'm going to replace this code with another test. Let's remove all of this stuff, place this one in. So we've got another test here that actually does an order by descending based on that GUID, so it has to sort potentially a bit of a random string, and then does a select. And it's, we're timing both ordering on LINQ and ZLinq. So let's run the app, see what happens. Let's go. So LINQ here is 109 milliseconds and ZLinq is 97 milliseconds. It's not great, but it's still an improvement there. I've figured out that you can actually make the difference even more stark. So if you go and do select, something like this, XX on it, and chain these along. Obviously, you'd never do this in real life, yeah? All right? But this is just a demonstration about how ZLinq is faster than LINQ. And we run the app. We'll actually see down here that the difference is even more stark. So we've gone from 310 milliseconds to 233 milliseconds. That's another third off the LINQ processing time just by using this legendary MVP's package that basically fixes LINQ. Now, I wonder what it would take to get this put into .NET 10 at the last minute. What do you think? Answers in the comments. Don't forget to like the video if you found this useful. Cheers.